Hey, everybody. See the girl standing there with a big smile. Oh, higher. To the left. Yeah, that's right. That's me. The big smile is pretty much a signature of me showing up in every single photo I'm in now. Just to be clear, 2 years ago, I didn't look this happy or open at all. I used to be quite shy, or rather serious. What triggered such a drastic transformation in me? Well, to answer that question, we need to go back in time. The first day I arrived at Ohio State, I was quite tense. I felt as if I was on an island with all these strangers. I wasn't alone, but quite lonely. Though the campus is very pretty in the fall, everyone was very friendly and tried to help me as much as possible. I just couldn't let loose. Deep down in my heart, I told myself to be clear with what I say and do so that I won't embarrass myself or other people. The first quarter at Ohio State, I took a really challenging math class for honors. The professor, who's also the vice chair of the math department, noticed my shyness and came up with the best way to overcome it. He sent me to a national conference. As the only representative from Ohio State University, I forced myself to talk and make friends with people from all the universities across the country. It all started with a small group of us trying to mess around with the idea of putting what we have learned from chemical engineering into real life. We played around with different kinds of commercial batteries and designed a fuel cell engine car and went all the way through national competition. Obviously, it takes more than just work to transform a reserved person like myself. We all need fun. At OSU, there's absolutely no way one can avoid such temptations. Going to a football game is something I could never forget. It is a time when I realized how proud I am to be a Buckeye, and it's also the time when I really just let it go, get crazy face paint, and shout out OHIO with the crowd. Springtime is the best time for outdoor activities. I took a big advantage of the beautiful campus area and developed the hobby of trail biking. When I bike along the Olentangy River Trail for miles and miles, all the nervousness and anxieties just don't seem to matter anymore. And it's so easy to merge myself into the arms of nature. The most mind-blowing part would be my trip to Africa. When the opportunity came for me to go with my professors to the actual African floodplain that we're doing research on, I almost couldn't believe it. For the first time in my life, I traveled with nomadic groups, shared food with tribes, camped on the savannah, slept under starry night, woke up by the sounds of the cattle, listened to children sing songs for me. Each and every single day there, I was amazed by the beauty of the dusk and dawn, thrilled by the greatness of the land, and moved by the purity of the people. It made me become grateful and realize how important it is to enjoy all the surprises life brings to me. Okay, here's the thing. Since life's a process that we all have to go through, we might as well have fun with it. No matter how worried we are, nothing's gonna stop or change. So why not put a smile on the face? This is just a glimpse of my 700 days of OSU. It's my story of studying in a foreign country. It's about learning about myself and the world, growing up, making friends, gaining confidence, and above all, having fun. It's all the memories I could never trade for being anywhere else. Well, I got another 500 days to go. No time to waste. Wanna join? Let's go.